Are you selling a product that has different sizes, designs, or colors? Let's have a look at how we can group them together on a single product detail page. If you have one or two variations for your product, then you can easily add your variations using an Add a Product wizard in three easy steps. But if you have numerous varieties in your product and you wish to add multiple colors and sizes there, in this case, Add a Product wizard could take forever to create that many variations. So we always use inventory file for this type of bulk upload. There are some common mistakes that people usually commit while creating variations in Amazon listing, especially when using inventory file template. And down the line, it can cause a lot of frustration and issues when we go create shipping plan, inventory replenishment, and moreover, your listing keeps getting suppressed and inactive. I'm gonna highlight and rectify these issues today so that you won't repeat the mistakes that I did at the first time. So, after watching this video, I'm sure you'll be able to create as many variations as you want with zero chance of error. Make sure you watch the video till the end to fully understand the do's and don'ts of using file template. Do you know the concept of variation family or child-parent listing? Let me tell you with an example. A product that has variations, we create parent listing first. Afterwards, we create child listings and attach all child listings to their parent. When people search for your product, they will see parent product in the search results. In reality, parent product has no physical presence. But when you open the parent listing, you will see the actual product available in the form of variations. Now, let's jump into my computer right away. As we are moving on, please hit the subscribe button below. Your one single subscription is my motivation. Now, open your Seller Central workflow. Click on Manage Inventory and Add a Product via Upload. You need to choose most relevant category for your product. Easy way is to just type and search. Pick your category and download the template. You may find a different template structure for your specific category, but major requirements are all same. So don't get confused and let's go to the next step. In this sheet, you can see the countless columns highlighted in different colors. We're only supposed to fill up the relevant fields in it, and I'm gonna tell you which fields are important that could save your time in replenishment and other processes. Feed the product type. You can find it from the drop-down, but sometimes the field doesn't show the drop-down, so you can simply click on Valid Value tab and get it from there. I've got 10 different bedsheet designs with 3 sizes each. So, I've got total 30 variations and 1 parent listing. Item SQ is an ID that you want to give it to each listing. So here, we can give it a name as bedsheet parent. And for the child listings, I've already saved the SQ names separately, so I just copy and paste it here. You can also leave it blank, then Amazon will automatically pick random SQs for all these listings. Write your brand name. External product ID is the UPC barcode that you purchase or get it from your manufacturer for each variation. Leave the parent row empty and fill the child rows with the UPCs. If you don't have UPC barcodes or if your manufacturer does not provide GTIN, then you can apply for UPC exemption. I have already created a detailed but brief video on how you can apply for GTIN exemption and get instant approval. Check the GTIN exemption tutorial link in the description of this video. Item name is the title of your product that shows in the search results, so make sure you create a title with the most relevant keyword in it. Put the manufacturer name same as your brand name that will help you easily approve your listing. Browse node is a series of numbers that represents the sequence of categories to subcategories. You can find the browse node from the other tab, simply copy and paste it. If you don't have this column, just move on, you never needed it. Leave the parent row empty for unit count, price, and quantity, but fill up the child rows accordingly. Unit count means how many units you have in one pack, and for the quantity, write the total number of stock available for sale. Remember, if you are planning to do FBA, just write 0 in the quantity field, and when you create a shipping plan for FBA, it will restock the quantity automatically. If you have the image URL, just put the main image since it will be showing in the search results. If you don't have a URL, just leave it blank and upload the images later from your computer. The variation section is a tricky and the most important element of the flat file template. Select parent for parent and child for child listings. Copy the parent SKU from the beginning and paste the parent SKU in the child rows. Make sure to leave the parent row empty. Select the relationship of your child rows as variation. Select the variation theme as per your product. For me, it's color size theme. Indicate if you want to delete or update your listing. Write a product description. You need to use relevant keywords in the description which can improve your SEO. Manufacturer part number is just a model number by your manufacturer. It is needed for some products. So if you don't have it, you may leave it blank. Fill up the 5 bullet points that represents the main features of the product. The size name and the color name are one of the most important elements to create variations correctly. Leave the parent row empty. Put all the color names and size names correctly to differentiate each variation. Go to the battery section. Batteries required. Indicate no to all. Last but not least, come to the FBA section and add the package length, width, height, and weight. Most of the people leave it empty, assuming it extra information. If you won't fill it now, you'll have to fill it later by opening and editing each variation manually. That's gonna consume a lot of time because you cannot create a shipping plan without this information. Save the file, go to the add product we upload, upload the file template, choose the relevant options, and upload the file. Wait for 10 to 15 minutes and boom, your all variations are up and running. I hope you like the way I convey my knowledge to you in a brief and different way. Let me know in the comment section, guys. And yes, please like and subscribe. Have yourself a blessed day.